Ja,
zien we ze wel.
En ook Texas Instrumenting.
Texas Instrumenting. En welkom to the Aterangi. Today we're reviewing Transformers 1.
That still only counts as one.
Not the first one.
Nou, it is the first one, apparently.
Yeah, we're not the B one. It is just Transformers 1.
Nee, het is produced by B.
That's the name of the movie.
This is Transformers 1.
Yes, indeed. The first one. They've never made one before.
Yeah. Indeed.
It's also the first one, chronologically.
Indeed.
That probably,
yeah. Yeah, no, it is. Like,
this is the farthest back we've ever been in any movie.
Buddy, really? More back is just background story.
More back is, and he said there will be light. Indeed. So we're playing Rivals of Aether with modded characters, because I didn't have anything else with robots and action in it. Barry is playing as V from Murder Drones. Simuli is playing as Gamma, well actually Kappa, from Sonic Heroes? Sonic Adventures?
Yeah, Sonic Heroes, Sonic Adventures. Yeah.
And I'm playing as legally distinct robot who turns into vehicles. He has a name, sure. But I forget.
Not important.
And we are all playing as him. I give us a random stage.
The pixel icon for my guy. Random map.
No data found. Location unknown.
In case you guys are wondering, we did not test any of these characters.
Yeah.
Yeah, a drill.
Okay! Alright, that's not in this one, is it? He turned himself into a car, funniest thing I've ever seen.
Alright, so what are we thinking of the movie, lads?
Great movie.
I enjoyed it. Expecting it to be kind of bad because I've heard that Transformers is usually not that great.
Usually not.
I've heard that it's usually just mostly explosions. Because it's a Michael Bay movie! But it was actually pretty decent.
But even so many percents of damage.
It's fine.
I wonder if he can attack the X to break the bridge. This map is not great for knocking people out.
I actually wonder what my taunt is.
Alright, so general thoughts on the movie, guys.
I enjoyed it a lot. Yeah.
Yeah, how am I not out of the map yet?
That can
because
be
this map is very terrible to smash someone out of.
Yeah, it's better
actually
than
enjoyed
I expected.
It, and the animation was really good.
You made a toy package.
Like, the only awkward thing about the animation are their mouths.
Yeah, the mouths are a bit weird. I'll just deal with it. Sound effects are a bit loud on my side. We'll deal with it in post.
Indeed. Editing Barry.
I know that Gamma has machine guns. Why don't I have guns?
So, spoiler free. This movie is better than I expected. It's honestly the environments look really nice, especially the surface, and especially the parts of the surface where like the mountains are just kind of forming. Let's see if we can find a clip of that. It looks really cool.
Simply just spamming the same move over and over again.
Yeah, but yeah, I only have
that
two
scene
moves.
Looks really cool, actually.
Yosh.
No!
I'm just standing here dead zoning you guys. Bye! Get out!
I don't think so.
Come on, guys. Opinions of the movie. Less game,
more
movie.
The environments were great. The characters also looked really cool, though. Like,
yeah, the characters look really nice, especially this one, the one prime that they meet. The main prime that they meet at all.
Oh, yeah. Like the mix between
I always forget
robot
his name.
Ninja.
I know that it's important.
You don't need his name right now, because that would be spoilers, I guess. For people who know the lore.
Yeah, but people might know the lore. Like, it's like, it is him.
For people who know the lore, like Sim. So Simli took us to this movie, and we did it in a 4D. We just backed through
each other. Yeah, so we went to our local cinema, and because the cinema kind of wants to die, I guess, they're not playing this movie in a proper language, in a regular cinema room, so we had to watch it in 4DX, which is like...
Which is like an amusement park ride with chairs that move, and there's wind and there's water and stuff.
Yeah, and there's like air and water and all that sort of stuff. During the advertisements, that was kind of a bit much. Like, it wasn't matched very well. During the movie, it was actually matched pretty well.
It was a bit too strong in the action scenes.
Yeah, in the action scenes, it like felt too strong. It was like being on the back of a bus on a dirt road.
Yeah.
And it kind of became hard to focus on the action.
Let's switch to some different robots here, lads.
Yeah, I'm first trying to do my audio a bit because the game is a little bit loud for me.
Yeah, it is. Same.
I'm gonna go for Wally. I wanna see if I can compact you guys.
Simli is Rob. Guess we're going for cute robots. I'll go R2-D2 then.
I can pick a Rob paint job.
Yeah, I think that's the main stuff for spoiler-free section. Like, it's pretty good. I think the ending villain is a bit weak. That's not the main villain. Yeah. There's a separate villain at the end. I think that's a bit weak how that's done. But in all, I would recommend the movie, especially if you're going with children. Yellow boys?
I wasn't expecting to like it as much.
Yeah, here's the score. We'll go over...
Both Simi and I going with the Bumblebee skin.
Here's the score. We'll go over what it means at the end. Alright, spoiler section.
Spoiler section. Indeed. No.
You can charge up that cube move.
I can make a rat climber.
That's not a rat, that's a cockroach.
Okay, I need to less focus on the game. Less spoiler.
Yeah, we're in the spoiler section now.
So, I like how we start just in a mine.
Yeah.
The mining is actually kind of cool. It looks like a run-based game, like DRG. Oh! Wait, Simli, get gonked upon.
What is that floor?
What is that floor? Oil. Now, this.
Okay.
Alright, so spoilers. Lads, what did we like? Come on.
The visuals. That's non-spoiler.
You can still say non-spoilers.
Yeah, I know.
No, it's
I'm starting to blank. I don't know why.
starting to more.
I like how we start off with like just a guy, well, start off, not really.
Yeah.
But like,
with like packs.
We see him like break into an archive and like run over. Like he actually like banters.
The escape scene
like,
was a lot of fun.
You know, let me run.
The escape scene was a lot of fun. In general, this movie is a lot of fun.
Yeah. I also liked how they established the beginning friendship of Orion and D16. Like, you can really see that they were good friends.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a nice way to portray a friendship like that.
Unfortunately, though, it's with D, the rest of his story is a bit on the weak side of things. Because,
yeah.
In case you don't know, like, spoilers, D turns into Magnetron, the warming boy.
But, like, it's like...
But, like, it feels very sudden.
Like gets,
it doesn't feel earned.
Yeah, but it makes sense. Like, you kind of get sick and tired of...
I mean, yes, but going from that to everyone has to die is a bit far.
Yeah, that's a bit far. Like... At the end, it goes very fast, where
yeah.
He's
like,
you know what, I've saved you. Like, I get that he's like, you know what, I've saved you too many times, I'm just gonna let you fall. But then to suddenly decide, you know what, I'm just gonna kill everyone, like, what? How do you get from, like, giving up on your friend because he keeps being an idiot to deciding everyone should die?
Yeah, I think it's
maybe
a bit...
Megatron.
I think it's a bit sudden. The formation of Megatron is the weakest part of the movie. But... It's still acceptable. Like, it's not completely unbelievable. It's just a bit stupid.
Yeah.
Yo, yeah, Barry, can you queue up, mate?
I was working on it.
Alright, next set of robots. Next beam.
I'll try this one.
I'll be Jenny. I think Prime and Bob-omb are the only two ones we haven't tried yet.
I'll try to be a bomb then. Because I'm the bomb. What colors does he have?
Go for gold.
Hell yeah.
I will
Bumblebee color scheme. I don't like the Bumblebee character.
Nah, Bumblebee isn't great.
What do you mean?
Like he's super
you,
weak.
Ah, you mean Bedazzatron.
He makes sense in the story, like, you know, but like, it's kind of...
His combat moves look cool.
His combat moves are really cool, but like, just the personality is like... he's like an annoying kid that literally never shuts up. And it makes sense in the story.
Like, that's what
like,
they were going for, but they didn't make it endearing enough.
Yeah, but it's also like... You know, they put him in, like, level 50. Wow, okay, we didn't know that ever existed. And then he's, like...
Yeah, they didn't know
like,
that existed.
With, like, trash that he basically puts together.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's fine. You'll start talking to yourself. You'll start talking
a bit of Wilsoning like, makes sense.
Apparently, he was even talking whilst knocked out. Like, that's a bit far, you know?
Y'all are silent now.
Actually, I'm Jenny from My Life as a Teenager.
Hey, what's up, Link?
What? I'm trying to figure out one of my moves.
I don't know what this does.
Which one, Barry? So the B are the special moves. That's the stuff that was weird stuff. The A is normal punches, and then your right stick is heavy attack.
Yeah, but like I can tick up the amount of damage I'm gonna do, and then like if I get myself on five and do this.
Oh yeah, yeah, you can.
He's going bye bye.
So awkward to me. This character.
Back onto the movie, lads.
Yes, indeed. We will cut this in post.
I like the theme. Like, I like the female.
The pink one.
Alita one.
Main character.
Alita Battle Angel.
Yeah, Alita Battle Angel.
I'm just gonna get all of the names wrong in this review on purpose.
I'm glad you're not the only
Barry
one
who remember.
Like, remembers her like that.
Remember,
well, like, she's also pink and all that sort
remember
of stuff.
Remember what?
Like. I am better than you. But remember, you have more hope.
Bye.
Bye.
I just realized that both Barry and I had died once and simply is out of lives.
Yeah. Because I need to control two characters, and if I want to do one character is suddenly out of range of the attack to do. How did you guys feel about Sentinel Prime?
Sentinel Prime was a fun primary villain, but it was extremely obvious second one that he was the villain.
Yeah, like I already knew that he was going to be a villain because if you follow lore a bit, sounds very.
Why did you follow me?
Why not, buddy?
I wanted to make sure you were dead.
Sentinel is never really a real prime, so I was like, yeah, it's probably a villain. Also, like that all the other primes were already dead.
Except for the one. This one, that looks cool as hell.
Yeah, but like...
I'm just a sucker for robots with moss on them.
Jesus. Alpha Trion.
Yeah, but like, robots with moss on them are pretty cool.
Yeah.
Indeed. Of course, Jenny had to win.
Of course.
She always does. Yeah, no, I like also the designs that they like, the way that they change when they get the cog.
Oh, yeah,
like
yeah,
that
yeah.
They actually become bigger.
Yeah, yeah. My only complaint I have about the cog is why is it in the area of the spark?
No, the spark is behind that.
Like most of the time the T-cog is in like where our kidneys are.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, positioning is a bit different. Alright, who's gonna be Optimus? Simili's gonna be Optimal Prime.
I already.
There's no other robots, but you're gonna have to pick one of the robots that's already existed.
Yeah, yeah.
Gonna be V.
I'll pick Obama.
I can be Movie Optimus.
To be fair, that's a robot.
I wanna pick R2-D2. I want a freaking Ninja Star!
I will be defense.
Yeah, no, like the characters were pretty alright, and especially the designs. Mm-hmm. Dude, we haven't even spoken about the trains.
What's with
yeah.
The
train?
What the hell or is this map?
for the people who have a fine eye.
Keyboard error. Press F1 to read.
For the people who have a fine eye here, you might notice that my moveset is Ridley from Smash. This is just Ridley from Smash who looks like V.
But like, does when you change the paint color, it doesn't change the moveset.
Why is unbalanced mode off?
I don't know. I don't know how Optimal Prime works.
Hey, Just so you know, there's a system error.
Yeah. I will get IT. IT said, you need to punch in the face! That was awesome for me.
Yeah, the trains, buddy.
The trains look really cool. I like that there's physics when they're inside the train. You know, the boxes fall and stuff like that. It's just like the train tracks, like how they just appear out of thin air.
Yeah, the roads.
And the roads.
In
well, Barry, oh, what happens is,
in the race was cool as
back rails and road just move forward.
Yeah, there's a very good like race section, like in
what is it with this review this channel movie. And having sick ass race sections in movies back to back? The previous review, we also mentioned a nice race section.
We just like nice race sections, okay? We're quite racist.
Well, I'm the biggest racist of them all, innit?
Alright, Barry, get out of here.
Damn. I'm trying to.
Ow.
Get out!
That sound! Just a punk!
Where was my sound? I don't have a time.
Yeah, the racing was really good. Another thing, the aliens or whatever they were, their ships
the
look really cool. Their technology is really cool. And the way that they grab the cubes of
Energon.
Of mined minerals is extremely interesting and awesome.
It's Energon! You heretic!
Dude, all of that jargon, I'm gonna forget. It's all on and whatever.
And Tron,
like, yeah.
I like that Barry hasn't used the oil spill fire combo even once. Down B places oil around you, yeah. And then and side smash is a fire move, as well as up B.
just
side heavy is a fire move. Like, stick to the side is a fire move.
Game!
Ah, you've got too much, right? What else we got, lads?
We have also cool jetpacks.
I mean, yes, but like, we don't need to mention everything in the movie. Just anything we think is important to say, my dude.
I was like, oh yeah, this is a cool inclusion of a boss, but I don't remember which one it was anymore. I was like, oh, this is cool.
The Dr. Like Ratchet gets mentioned.
Yeah, Ratchet gets mentioned.
I love
Ratchet
how you
is...
walked out when that one character just appeared. You were like,
yeah.
I'm out.
So at one point I had to go to the toilet. So obviously I walked out the moment Starscream appears, because of course I do. Screw Starscream.
I cannot figure out this fire move, Klaus.
Oh, simply give Barry a second. What can't you figure out, Barry?
How to trigger it?
You use any of your moves that have fire. So up B or side smash. Yeah, if you hit it with your jets, it will go off. And if you hit it with side smash, which is your stick. Your stick? No, the other side. Side means you need to... that one. If you do that one above the oil, it also sets it off. And that fire does a lot of damage.
I didn't even know you could use that stick for attacks, by the way.
Oh, that's your heavy attacks. That's to send people flying.
Yeah, it's just
so I've been playing without that.
Well, it's the same as Smash Bros. You knew how to do it in Smash Bros.
I guess I never thought of it. I'm not a Smash Bro.
Last time I played was with you guys.
Yeah. I'm someone
I
always
bought Smash so I can actually, you know, like learn how to play games.
Alright, so here's the thing, lads. Anything left to say on the movie before we go to the scoring?
How is there grass or...
Yeah, that's an interesting one.
On a planet that's fully made out of metal.
Yeah, even like the rocks and stuff are metal, which is pretty cool.
I think it's probably like a leftover thing from the Quintessence because they are more biological. Like,
yeah, it might be their trash.
Things have come.
Alright, lads, you can pick whatever you want for behind the scoring sheet. It doesn't have to be robots now. Alright, let's blast through the beginning of this scoring screen. We gave it a green score, movie's okay. It does not get a novelty checkmark, because movie's existing. Brow is below average around Y. Come on, Barry, keep up.
Come on, Barry.
Yo, you're going
fast. We said Y.
It's around Y, it's like there's a lot of jargon, but like you don't need to understand what the jargon means to follow the movie, so it doesn't matter.
It's basically like a hacking scene in movies. The end. They just tap the keyboard a bit and then they go, I'm in.
Acting is not great, I think, what about you guys? It wasn't like distractingly bad, but it wasn't good.
I would just leave
I didn't really notice, but
oh, yeah. I would just leave it in the middle.
It's passable. Yeah. The story. It's a bit of a weird one.
I mean, the story is just a simple, like. Well, it's a combination of the standard, like, the guy everyone likes is secretly the bad guy. And Moses. It's a combination of Moses and the guy everyone likes is secretly the bad guy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. But the Transformer story itself has also been told like 5 million times.
Yeah, but this is a difference. This is like...
Yeah, but this version of it has also been told. Not in a movie, but it's been told.
Yeah, yeah, it's been told.
Like, with words.
In different ways, maybe very short. Like literally like, oh yeah, one scene is like everything we get of it.
Honestly, it's well thought. I'm thinking 60s. Maybe low 70s.
I'd all do that.
Like, it's a simple story, but it's well thought.
It checks out.
Everything
where did the color go?
Buddy, where did the color go?
Color decided to yield itself.
Oh, so there it is.
So the score
slightly. That was a bit funny.
Welcome to the live scoring sheet. That happens.
Zet disnichten.
Disnichten?
Disnichten.
Disnichten?
Disnichten.
Alright.
Zet design, buddy.
Pay attention. Mm-hmm. Architecture. Honestly, I think the buildings are boring. And that's like the only design thing that's like boring in this.
Yeah, it's pretty basic.
It's the type of buildings you get if you type into YouTube Blender Sci-Fi City tutorial.
Yeah, I mean that is like.
Yeah, actually, like I'm pretty sure we could make this.
So I would just leave that half. Like it's not bad.
It's faithful but boring.
Yeah, I would just leave it there. For props, what we got with props?
I'll give
the train.
It a 4 or 5.
The train is a prop. The train is.
The dier is a prop.
What's a prop?
The dier. I decided that they are prop.
I think the dier is a character.
Yeah.
There are multiple
but props. But the props are good.
The props are good, but there's not too many interesting ones.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the matrix of leadership isn't too interesting of an object. It's just a MacGuffin.
Yeah, and it looks traditional.
But this is a very cool prop.
I was expecting more of the cogs.
Yeah. But this is a very
like
cool
a
prop.
With, like,
yeah,
on it.
It's weird that it's a ball, but that's just how it is. So, what is cool with the props that we didn't talk about in the regular review? I like the sand holograms. They're cool as hell.
Yeah, they're cool. They're cool.
Yeah, yeah.
So let's give props like... in the 70s?
I can do that. Environment?
So environment, we've got a few things there that count under this.
We've got the cityscape. We got
That's all architecture.
That's architecture.
Yeah, but it's like...
And environment
like
is more nature.
Like,
yeah, it's more like outside stuff. You've got the mine. That's an environment.
The mine
got
is
the
an
surface.
The surface is cool as hell with the forming rocks. Play the clip again if you found it. Laugh at me if we didn't. Not you, Simi.
I left it, buddy.
Can we just
or myself.
I kind of want to go high on the environment.
Yeah, let's give it like high 70s, low 80s. Because the outside looks very interesting. Especially the parts that have nature in it. The nature in this movie looks great. The nature in this sci-fi robot movie looks excellent.
On the robot planet. It's a robot
what,
planet.
What do we like? What do we say about the world building, or did we just skip it because it's Transformers?
What do you mean? We haven't done sound yet.
We started in acting, then, and we're going around.
Yeah. Ah, you're going around the circle.
Yeah.
You haven't noticed yet.
No, I haven't caught on, my boy.
Ah, it's sound.
I'm a cogless bot. I can't think very well.
Fair. Yeah. Nice cog.
Thank you.
Alright. So, what did we think of the music? I didn't think anything of it.
Yeah.
That was music?
I think I like it, but I don't remember anything of the music anymore.
I think that means it stays exactly half, right?
Yeah.
I knew there was music, but it didn't get me for anything.
I don't remember wow, this is a cool soundtrack, or
I
just don't remember any.
I didn't even notice them sneaking Transformers team in there or something.
Yeah, me neither. What about the
It probably was in there.
Probably.
But I just didn't notice.
The big game sounds.
Yeah, I should have noticed something like that.
Yeah. Alright, how about
why
the
didn't
big
I
game
notice?
The sound design is
The steps for a big character.
Mm-hmm. It's almost as if I can feel them.
How would that be?
The mountains forming at a nice sound happen.
Yeah. Just
a
nice
like 60?
Yeah. Then let's talk about the mix.
I think the mix just gets it's a modern movie, so it's 70s to 90s somewhere. Right? Did you guys have any mixing troubles?
No, I don't think so.
It was aight. The music was there, it just wasn't very noticeable because it wasn't standout music, but...
Mm-hmm. It was existing music.
But it was existing, and it was one wasn't overpowering the other, so...
Right, that brings us to the...
Probably after this, just look up the music, they always do it the movie.
I mean, it's probably pretty good.
I was thinking of doing it yesterday, but I was like, I'm tired.
I don't know why, but the only song that I can come up with right now is one of the theme songs from Jurassic Park.
Yeah, that was because it was playing during the ads.
Yeah,
probably.
That brings us to the weirdest topic for this movie, world building. So first things first.
This is
to look at the world building of Transformers. You need to start off by accepting that it doesn't make any sense.
Yes.
Logically, the world doesn't make any sense.
But Klaus, just hear me out for a minute, okay? In the first few frames of the movie, or in the first 15 minutes of the movie, we literally see the planet being built from the ground up.
Yeah, no, that was what I was getting at. There's a lot of world building.
So I think no movie can beat this one. The world building is
out of gets life. Built. In fact, halfway through the movie, we see the world itself being rebuilt again when the mountains change shape.
I'm thinking we give it up.
Yeah, sounds fair.
Sounds fair. Now, the world building obviously doesn't make much sense, but there's a lot of history and lore, and there's how actual things came to be.
Yeah, this is a world built. This whole movie is building world.
Yeah,
world.
So I'm thinking it's gonna be at least. Well. Let's say in the 70s.
Mm-hmm. The thing is,
it's not an excellent piece of world building material, because you can't do that with Transformers, because at its very essence, the world cannot make sense.
Yeah, a very positive thing about this movie is, you can put this
engage.
At the beginning at most continuities. Most, not all. A good example is Transformers Animated.
Yeah, Transformers Animated would be good.
Yeah. But a lot of other, in the broad strokes, you can take this movie.
Godzilla heavy stroke whilst listening to this.
Having a stroke is always an option.
Indeed.
Right, visuales.
The visual looks good, except the mouse.
Alright, so first things first, style. I think style is just
regular CG movie.
Yeah.
Off to the.
Yeah, so I think style is gonna have to stay in the middle, because there's no like. It's literally the standard.
Don't compare it to the movie with the actual movie, by the way. That only makes it worse.
No, of course, that wouldn't be fair, because that's. That's not really fair, because that's
dripping in style. I just did, and this movie dropped like far, but like every movie would, so.
But this is gonna have to stay like middle, because it's what you would expect, right?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yeah.
It's just basic. Mm-hmm. Consistency!
I think consistency drops because the mouths are not good. But just a bit.
Like that's why I did my own. Like, you get used to the mouths.
Yes. I mean, yes. But on that but one prime, it looks so much better when it's just a separate segment that moves.
Yeah, it's just him.
Yeah, actually, yeah.
Just only an Alpha Trion, it looks good.
I just don't get why you would give a robot a regular fake.
I mean...
In that prime...
I mean, let's be fair here, Murder Drones does the same thing.
Yes, but Murder Drones does the same thing in an interesting concept.
Also, Murder Drones is in a way more cartoony style.
Yeah. That's... The mouths are part of the body, which is... But the eyes?
The eyes are a screen, yeah.
Are a screen, which kind of makes a lot more sense. So...
All
besides,
right.
Like, half of Murder Drones doesn't make any sense. Like, what even is an absolute solver?
Well, as a person who works at the solver factory... then I think quality is gonna be like 70s.
Yeah, it was pretty good quality.
It's good quality. Which brings us to the final chapter of this scoring screen. The Chiripdises.
Chiripdises?
The Chirassarassarass.
I mean, they do be rolling.
Autobots! Fill your roles! Right, so first things first. I think Optimist Primus does a pretty good job.
Yes.
I mean,
filling his role of Moses, basically. He's Moses.
Yes.
He does a good job of that. The D16 does not, in my opinion, not fill a... He does this role of being the friend good. He doesn't do the villain well.
Yeah, I see what you mean. Like with becoming Megatron, like a bit too suddenly.
Yeah.
Like there should have been there is something missing, like a little bit.
Yeah, like it doesn't feel like he earns the snap.
Like that snap was a little bit too forced, too soon.
A bit forced.
Dude felt the villainship faster than seemingly could roll a dice for perception.
-3.
He came back negative.
How do you get -3? There is a...
Alita honestly doesn't have much of a role, and I feel like she's just there to try to sell toys to girls.
Yep.
Like, she's a fun character, like, she's not making the movie worse, but...
Yeah,
she doesn't
like
react to
like
anything.
The fact that she's like super motivated and stuff, and then like I get that like he wants her by his side at the end of the movie.
Yeah, but she basically.
But like, she's there.
She literally fills the role of the that one girl character in each movie.
Yeah, and
just like motivating the hero in his dark moment is what every single girl character in any movie ever
is. And the sad part is, like, you could have made her awesome. Because, like, even in the fighting scenes, it's mostly focused on our main optimistic boy and D16.
And a bit of B.
Ah, yes. Badassitron.
And a bit of Badassitron. But, like, you barely get to see her in action, and I feel like she was kind of also kick-ass.
Yes, you're supposed
to
be the complete
one.
But Alita's in general always complete.
Yeah. But I feel that the directors were like, you know what, we've already released Alita Battle Angel, so...
We don't have to do it twice.
You can't do it twice, you know?
And then B. B fell flat. Yeah. Like, you can see what his role is, he just doesn't do it well.
Comedy relief.
He's like the comedic relief, slightly crazy character. He's like the island hermit that you find on in the pirate movie.
Yeah. They should make a parody story about him.
Why is the rum gone?
Why is the rum gone? No, so, for the rules, all in all, oh yeah, and the remaining cool-looking Prime does a good job of being an exposition guy and a bit of a guide.
Yeah.
He's fun to listen to.
And Sentinel Prime was a good villain, I guess.
Yeah, but with a name like Sentinel, like, you already know he's gonna be a bad
guy. He's a bit of a, like, a plank of wood.
Yeah.
Like, he's a sturdy base, but there's no personality to him at all.
Like, except like, ooh, look how great I am. Ooh.
Yeah, but that's like...
I am Sentinel Prime.
That's every single one of the he's the liked character, but secretly the villain
that's
character.
That's almost every single Sentinel Prime.
Yeah, but also that's every single time you have that popular character.
Why am I only specifically thinking about the animated version?
Because the animated version is the best version. And Starscream exists. I wouldn't know. I left the room.
Somebody, what do you think of Starscream?
Who?
Starscream, the leader of the, like, rebels on the surface.
Oh, the guy who got like 5 seconds of screen time and then died? Yeah.
He didn't die. Starscream joins up with modern food heating guy at the end.
I had to think on that one for a second, but I got it. I wonder if the fans got that one.
Yeah, they, of course they will get it.
So do we knock off a couple of points for roles, or do we just leave it at 50?
I think we leave it, because it's a bit of a wash. There's good characters, there's bad characters.
Yeah.
They got the main guy good, they got the guide guy good. The villain for most of the movie is neutral.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we leave them.
The deer were amazing. They filled their role
okay.
Really well.
Design.
The designs... The Cochlus designs are uninspired. The Cocht designs are good.
Yeah, but I think that's the point.
Yeah, that is the point.
Cochlus.
That is the point.
And I like the fact that they like actually grow if they have a cog.
They're like physically larger.
Mm-hmm.
Also, the actual
like
primes
cock,
look cool as hell.
Larger.
Indeed. They always look cool as hell.
And yeah, can we get
evil
like
surface
more...
aliens are also cool.
Can we get a movie on like the original primes in the way that they were animated in this movie? Because like I feel that would be great.
Transformers minus one.
Transformers zero.
Nah. Just minus one. You know, just Transformers minus.
Yeah, I think designs... I think this is among the best the Transformers have looked.
Yes.
Is it the best? Probably not.
Well, I know what the design-wise they beat.
Hmm?
Come on, say it with me. Beast Wars.
Ah yes, they do beat Beast Wars. I mean, depending on your tastes, animated might be the best ones. Or... I forget the name for the other one that might be the best ones.
I have no clue.
It's not the live actions, in my opinion. They look too busy.
Yeah. Are you thinking of Prime?
I have absolutely no
Perhaps
clue
it's
about
Prime.
Any of these.
Yeah, Barry does not know anything. You know nothing, Barry Snow.
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, personalities shine here. The personalities on all of the characters are pretty good. Like, I would say 80s.
Yeah.
And that brings us at the score. Any closing statements?
This movie existed?
That this movie still counts as one.
One.
No, it's better than I expected
when
it to
one,
be.
You need to play the clip.
Would I have gone to watch this in the cinema or at home? If my friend Simli did not drag me into this movie, probably not. Was it better than I expected?
Yes, you went to watch it in the cinema because I dragged you to the cinema.
Yeah. Would I recommend people watch this movie? Actually, yeah, kinda.
If you're watching with children, definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
If you're watching it on your own or with buddies as an adult, there's probably better options. But I guess if you watch a movie with your buddies every night, perhaps you ran out of good options and then this is a worthy shot.
Yeah.
But if there's kids in the room, good shot. Take this one. Worth it.
Yes.
Family movie. An actual one.
Yeah. Finally.
And we'll see you next time.